Would you like to have QuickBooks help you calculate your estimated income taxes? Well, in this video, you will learn how to make a profit and loss statement that includes only taxable income. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. QuickBooks can help you estimate how much tax to send in. You can create a special income statement in QuickBooks that would only include your non-exempt includable income and only expenses that the IRS considers deductible. This profit and loss statement will never be perfect. You will never calculate your taxable income in QuickBooks exclusively, but it will help you estimate for your quarterly estimated income taxes. You see, the federal and state tax authorities only expect an estimate when you send in your quarterly federal tax payments with a voucher that looks very similar to this. For federal taxes, Form 1040-ES requires that you take the numeric results from your bookkeeping and follow the steps in the publication 1040-ES, to find how much estimated taxes you need to send in. The safest thing you can do if you are keeping accurate home finance bookkeeping records is to use the profit and loss for the specific fiscal quarter that you must send in the taxes. Set the dates in the profit and loss the same way that we learned in the previous video. Compare the net income for that month or quarter to the tax rate schedules that are included in the publication. And that's how you will know how much money to send in for estimated taxes. And if you do it that way, you will be safe and send in an amount that will keep you safe. But remember, you would only want to consider, for those calculations, taxable income. And taxable income is the result of two things. Your includable items of income, which they call non-exempt income, which is only what you are required to include and report. The IRS makes clear by creating publications what kinds of income should or should not be included in your taxable income calculation. You also have to know your deductions. Again, the IRS makes clear by creating publications what kinds of expenses should or should not be deducted from your taxable income calculation. So you need to separate all your income and expenses into two types. The income should be split into non-exempt or exempt income, and the expenses should be split into either deductible or non-deductible income. In short, you either include the item in your tax calculation or you do not include the income and or expense item in your tax calculation. So, you need two separate profit and loss statements in order to accomplish this. One that has only tax return items that are includable on the return, and another income statement that includes everything, all income and expense items. Now, in order to accomplish that, you have to create what's called classes in QuickBooks. Classes are a way of tracking accounting information into helpful to manage categories. You must activate class tracking in the preferences window. Then you have to put in the list of classes that you will use. Now, our two classes will be called non-exempt income or deductible expenses, and those are the things that we will include on the profit and loss to calculate the estimated taxes. And then everything else that we will not include in the profit and loss that will help us calculate our estimated taxes, like exempt income or non-deductible expenses. Then each time we make a transaction that involves income or expense, we will simply choose the proper class from the class list that will then be displayed in the window. Then we can open up the profit and loss by class, and we can see our taxable income compared to our overall income. So let's go ahead and do this. First, we will activate class tracking in the preferences window. From the main menu, click Edit Preferences. The category of preference will be accounting, and then you click Company Preference, and you have the ability to click this option, Use Class Tracking for Transactions. We click this here, and we click OK. Now you can see if we click Lists, we now have a new list added to the list of lists called the Class List. And now we will put in the list of classes. Our two classes will be non-exempt / deductible, which are things that we will include, and then the other class will be exempt income and non-deductible expenses, which will be things that we will not include, or at least not include as part of our estimated tax calculation. So non-exempt deductible, so we click list, class list, then like most list windows, we click the bottom left and we click new. Now, the name of the class, again, for the things that we will include, non-exempt deductible. Non-exempt are the things that we will include. Next, then the name of the class that shows what we will not include, exempt income and non-deductible expenses. So we'll just put exempt non-deductible and click OK. And now you can see that these two classes will be available to choose for each income and expense related transaction. Now, we can choose the class when we go to make a transaction, and then after we do that, we will open the profit and loss by class, and we will see the taxable or the estimated taxable net income that we will use as a basis to compare to the tax rate schedules for sending in estimated taxes. So now let's assign classes to the existing transactions. You would normally record the class at the moment you record the transaction. We must add a class to all prior transactions so that the profit and loss by class will be clear. I will show you some, then I will pause the video and finish. You can pause the video as well, and we will compare reports. So let's imagine only landscaping income is exempt and only vet bills and dining out are not deductible. Just keep that in mind when we come back here. So this is how we will start today, because we're not entering the transactions fresh. We're opening up the original profit and loss, which does not have anything separated by class yet, and use the profit and loss to open up the transactions that we will change. Again, you wouldn't normally do it this way. We're simply changing transactions that were entered in the past so that they can be put in the proper class. So let me just expand this down here. Okay, so watch how we do this. Bartending income, These are all includable. So I will open up each deposit. Now notice, when you go back to the original transaction, you now have a column for class. And then you would put in non-exempt deductible, because the bartending income is non-exempt and belongs on the tax return. Save and close. Yes. Do see, now it says, shows you the class. You can make this column wider. Double click this. All bartending income is non-exempt. You have to include it. Save. Yes. And then you see the class. Double click. It's non-exempt. Save. Yes. And it's the same thing with this check. I think maybe there was a refund. I don't know the context. You have to look at the prior video. But it's not exempt. Save. Yes. There we go. But you see the landscaping income is exempt. Double click the one transaction for landscaping, and you'll put exempt income. Save and close. Yes. Now we've done all of the income accounts. Now when you do the expense accounts, delivery is deductible. Double click. The class it belongs in is a non-exempt deductible. Save and close. Yes. See? Double click. This is deductible. And so on. Now, of course, I will finish the delivery expense off camera. But what I want to show you is dining out is this one check here, and it is not deductible. Save and close. You will not include it in your estimated taxes. What about the vet bills? Double click. Double click for the transaction itself. Vet bills are not deductible. Exempt, not deductible is the category. Okay, very good. So I'm going to basically finish these other two. It should only take a second. This is deductible. This is deductible. Now, again, there's only a couple of, I guess this, we should probably just finish up. Electricity and telephone, you should do off camera. Pause the video and see if you can do it. Now, when we finish, you shouldn't see any differences on the main overall profit and loss. The only noticeable difference would be opening an account and seeing that in the new class column, there is a class assigned. And now we get to the main point. From the main menu, click Reports, Company and Financial, Profit and Loss by Class, which is now available because we activated classes in the Preferences window. And when we open it up, just for now, push A on your keyboard so you can see the results of all dates. Now, notice the major items on the bottom we didn't really give a class to. We forgot to do that, but don't worry. But basically, take a look at this. Your non-exempt or deductible column, this column here, is the column that you use to send in the estimated taxes. So here's all the income that you will include. Here are all the expenses that you will deduct. So this would be a general, not perfect estimate of your taxable income for whatever time period you're looking at. And it is the $735 that you would then bring over to the tax rate schedules in order to determine how much estimated taxes you would need to send in for that quarter. Again, be careful, because you might have to send in estimated taxes based on the extraordinary items that are under operating income. We could have given them, well, the $7,000 really is not includable, but the $500 loss on theft is deductible if you have a police report. So we can double click this, and we can make this exempt, save and close. See, and then it shows up in the proper column and does not affect the estimated taxes. What about this $50 here that's still unclassified? This $500 still unclassified. This is, when we double click, this is deductible. A theft loss is deductible if you're itemizing as well as having a police report. So now you can see for this quarter, you only have to use $235 to bring to the tax rate schedules to estimate your taxes because you included the deductible expenses for that particular time period. So you would run this report and you would put a from date for the beginning of the fiscal quarter. You would put a to date for the end of the fiscal quarter. Then you would click refresh and use this column as your safest bet to bring to the tax rate schedules to estimate your quarterly taxes. This column is your overall net income and expense for that quarter or whatever time period you isolate. And by the way, this left column means nothing. It is an arbitrary number. It's just the result of whatever you don't have to include in income combined with whatever you're not allowed to deduct. So this left column is a meaningless number. This is the column you use to decide how much to send in estimated taxes for the quarter. And this is your overall income and expense and profit for the quarter.